I will cease to admonish you about anything. Do as you think best, seeing the confidence I have in you. Whenever you think there is anything wherein I can serve you, I shall be ready to do so. After you have, according to your promise, reinstated me in my authority. Meanwhile, I will have patience, contenting to devote myself entirely to you without exception. I cannot refrain from assuring you how happy I should esteem myself if you would be pleased to permit me to make it my duty to recover by means whatever some portion of your good graces, in which I most earnestly wish you'd be pleased to aid me by some intimation in what way you think I can gratify and obey you, whenever it is your pleasure. I shall always be ready to give you proofs of the honor and friendship I bear you. I have it on the authority of Lady Shrewsbury that Elizabeth is not as other women, having only the smaller opening through which she passes water. It is said she believes herself to be so beautiful that she resembles a goddess of the skies. Furthermore, this ridiculous monster of vanity has lain in bed with the Earl of Leicester many times, and the frog that came a-wooing the Duc d'Alençon, and his gentleman-in-waiting, Jean Simier. Also, when Sir Christopher Hatton resisted her advances, she took him by force. I was very glad that you were pleased to accept the sweetmeats which I sent you, and would to God that you would accept my services in more important things, in which I should show such readiness to please that in a short time you would have a better opinion of me. In the meantime, I will wait patiently for some favorable news from you, which I have been expecting for such a long time.
We have had here, even in my chamber, a great earthquake on the evening of Saturday. I have heard that it was at the same hour and day in several other places of this country. God, by his mercy, deliver us from evil.
But I ought not to fear that he will let worse befall me than he has already done. God, preserve us all. Since the weather doth cut off all exercise abroad, I pass the time with my needle, and the diversity of the colours makes the work seem less tedious. And I continue so long at it, the very pain makes me give it over.
Send me, as soon as you can, 8 ells of crimson satin, the best that you can find in London, and 1 pound of thinner and double silver thread, which you will be able to get woven. Patterns of dresses and samples of cloth of gold and silver, and silk, the most beautiful and rare that are worn at court. Obtain for me from Italy the newest fashions in headdresses and veils and ribbons, and I will repay whatever they may cost. I beg you to send me some genuine terra sigillata, if it is to be had for money, and a bit of fine unicorn's horn, as I am in great want of it.
The best and most secret writing is with alum, dissolved in a very little clear water,
24 hours before you wish to write. And to read it, it is necessary only to dip the paper into a basin of clear water. The secret writing appears white, very easily read, until the paper becomes dry again. You can, in this way, write on white taffeta or white cloth, especially lawn.